جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي يجيبني حين أناديه ويستر علي كل عورة وأنا أعصيه ويعظم النعمة علي فلا أجازيه. نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، إلها واحدا أحدا فردا صمدا قيوما، نؤمن له بالربوبية ونقر له بالعبودية. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد، كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. وصل اللهم وسلم على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والأوصياء والصديقين وعترة نبيك الطيبين الطاهرين والخلص من أصحابه المنتجبين ومن تبعهم بإحسان وإيمان إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. التائبون، العابدون، الحامدون، السائحون، الراكعون، الساجدون، الآمرون بالمعروف والناهون عن المنكر، والحافظون لحدود الله، وبشر المؤمنين. صدق الله العلي العظيم. There are two types of beauties in this life. One is the external and the outer beauty. Beauty that is based on materialism. Beauty that depends on jewelry, on garments, on precious stones, gold, silver. But there is another type of beauty, the interior one, the inner beauty, the beauty that depends on manners, on behavior, on character, on how we conduct ourselves, how we deal with people around us. It's very good that if we can gather both types of beauties, the external and the internal. Beauty that comes from clothing and garments, and the beauty that comes from character and behavior. But if we could not gather both, then the second one is more important than the first one. The beauty of the character, the beauty of the manners, the beauty of the soul that depends on a pure soul, soul that God created and wanted it to remain all the time, to remain pure, immaculate. The beauty that depends on wholesomeness and goodness and love and care for all a human being, all those people who live around us. That is the real beauty. And if we can focus on this type of a beauty, then we can build our own happiness in this life. Our journey in this life is going to be a journey of content, qana'ah, journey of satisfaction, journey of faith, and journey of success. If we can embrace the second type, embrace, promote the second type of a beauty. As to the first one, Allah says, beauty and attraction and personal adornment that is based on materials, it's going to go one day. فَأَمَّا الزَّبَدُ the froth, زَبَد is the froth, the scum. فَيَذْهَبُ جُفَاءً it is going to go away. Go away as dross. Go away. فَيَذْهَبُ جُفَاءً. Becomes useless. وَأَمَّا مَا يَنْفَعُ النَّاسِ. But what is going to benefit mankind, فَيَمْكُثُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Remains in the land. It is foundational. And this is the beauty of the character. The beauty of the akhlaq. This one stays. Stays even if we leave physically. But our beauty remains behind us. People are going to say such and such came in this community, in this street. He used to work here, he used to live here, and he did such and such good things for his neighborhood, for his community, for people at large. وَأَمَّا مَا يَنْفَعُ النَّاسَ فَيَمْكُثُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. This is the real investment. People remember his or her sacrifice and contribution and service that he or she did to the community. فَيَمْكُثُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Remains, does not go away. One of the leaders that focused on the second, though she was beautiful physically, but her focus and her intention was on the second part. The beauty of akhlaq, the beauty of character, was Lady Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salatu wassalam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Who passed away like today, 13th of Jumad al-Awwal. She was the nearest person to the heart of the Prophet. No one could rival her in being number one, occupying number one position in the heart of her father, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And because of her nearness to her father, she was the very first person among his family to join him in the hereafter. أنتي أول أهل بيتي لحوقا بي. This is exactly what he said to her. Ya Fatima, you're going to be the first member of my family to join me soon. And the separation did not go long, either 75 or 95 days between her father's departure and her departure. Sahih al-Bukhari in two books, two different chapters, Kitabu Bad' al-Khalq, the creation, the beginning of the existence, in his chapter, and another chapter about marriage, Kitabu al-Nikah. He says twice that the Prophet said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْضَى لِرِضَى فَاطِمَةَ وَيَغْضَبُ لِغَضَبِهِ. Fatima is reflection of God's satisfaction or God's anger. So if she becomes angry, this means God is angry. If she becomes happy with someone or something, this means God is happy with that thing or that person. Twice in Sahih al-Bukhari, this hadith has been narrated. She was the reflection of God's feelings. And she did not attain this position just because she was the daughter. She happened to be physically the daughter of the Prophet. She attained that through her akhlaq, through her sacrifice, through her patience. I mentioned a few examples of her patience and her sacrifice last night, and I will continue on some others today. Abu Nu'aym al-Isbihani, one of the great historians, in his book, Hilyatul Awliya, from the book of Ahlus Sunnah, he says that one day the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam akhbara ashabahu anna Fatimata waji'ah. That Fatima is sick today. So let's go and visit her. So he left the masjid with his companions and they came to visit, which is next door. Next door, it was almost inside the masjid. Inside the masjid, her door. They knocked at the door. She was there. And the Prophet said to her, I am with my companions. We came to visit you, to check on you. She said, Ya Rasulallah, ما علي عباءة. I have nothing to cover myself with it. Fatima, the daughter of the Prophet, she does not have aba'ah to cover herself. So the Prophet, from behind the door, a'ta laha rida'an, behind the door, he stretches his arm and he gives her, to his daughter, a cover to cover herself. And the Sahaba, they came. They sit there for some time. When they left, they said, Tallahu bintu nabiyyina ala hadha al-hal. We can't believe that Fatima, the daughter of the Prophet, she doesn't have aba to cover herself. The answer came from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qal, ama innaha sayyidatu nisa'il alameen. Yes. Yes, because she's the master of the ladies. So don't be surprised if the daughter of the Prophet does not have a piece of garment to cover herself. Don't be surprised. This is why she's the lady, the master of the ladies of this world and the next. The second example again in Kitabu Musnad al-Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, in his book, An Anas ibn Malik, one of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anna Bilalan. Bilal was the muadhin, and he has to be on time in the masjid for his adhan. One day in the morning, he did not show up. Bilal came late. فسأله رسول الله ما حبسك, what detained you from coming on time and raising the adhan? Bilal said, يا رسول الله مررت بفاطمة, while I was coming to the masjid, I passed by the house of Fatima. I heard the cry of the baby. He doesn't say which baby, which one of those four babies who are at the house of Fatima. But he says a male baby, so it could be Hassan or Hussein. So I sought permission. I entered the house. وَهِيَ تَطْحَنُ وَالصَّبِيُّ يَبْكِي. She was grounding the flour, preparing the food, the bread, while the baby was alone, crying. So I said to her, either I do the job for you, ground the flour, or I take care of the baby. She said, I'll take care of my baby. Ana arfaqu bi ibni mink. I know how to deal with this baby. So if you can help me preparing the food. فَهَذَا الَّذِي حَبَسَنِي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. I was helping your daughter Fatima at home. فَقَالَ لَهُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. The Prophet said to him, رَحِمْتَهَا يَرْحَمُكَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. You helped my daughter. You had mercy on her. I ask Allah to bestow his mercy on you. Another story. The Prophet, this story has been mentioned in the three credible books of tafsir. When they come to the explanation of verse 37 in Surah Al-Imran, speaks about Maryam. كُلَّمَا دَخَلَ عَلَيْهَا زَكَرِيَّا الْمِحْرَابَ وَجَدَ عِنْدَهَا رِزْقًا. Whenever Zakaria comes into her sanctuary, he finds some food. And he would ask her, where do you bring this food from? قَالَتْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. This is from my Lord. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Truly, God would send provision to whomever he likes without measurement. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam أَقَامَ أَيَّامًا لَمْ يُطْعَمْ طَعَامًا. This is your Prophet. He spent days, they don't say how many days, but days he did not eat food. فَشَقَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَيْهِ. It became very difficult for the Prophet. فَطَافَ عَلَىٰ مَنَازِلِ أَزْوَاجِهِ فَلَمْ يَجِدْ عِنْدَ وَاحِدَةٍ مِّنْهُنَّ شَيْئًا. So he went to the rooms of his wives. Also he did not find something to eat. فَأَتَى فَاطِمَةَ عَلَيْهَا السَّلَامِ. This hadith is mentioned in Al-Zamakhshari, Al-Suyuti, and Al-Tha'libi. Three of the exegists, the Mufassireen of the Holy Quran in the school of Sunnah. So he came to the house of Fatima searching for food. Again, Fatima, his daughter, she apologized to him. She said, Ya Rasulullah, there is no food at home, at our home. So the Prophet stayed there for a while and then he left. As soon as he left, بعثت إليها جارة برغيفين وقطعة لحم. Immediately, one of her neighbors, she sent some food, two loaves of bread and piece of meat. So when Fatima saw this, قالت والله لأؤثرن بهذا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله على نفسي وولدي. I'll give a preference to the Prophet with this food. I would not eat it. Me and my children would not eat this food, but we will give it to the Prophet. So she sent Hassanan or Husaynan, either one of them, to the Prophet. And he said to the Prophet, he went to the masjid, he said, Ya Rasulullah, good news. My mother says, come back. The Faraj has arrived. So he came back. He said to her, Ya Fatima, where do you bring this food from? She said, Ya Rasulullah, huwa min indillah, inna Allah yarzuqu man yasha'u bighayri hisab. The same Lord who took care of Mary when she was alone. The same generous Lord is taking care of Fatima alayhi salam. And the Prophet puts his hand on that food and he blesses the food. And then he invites Ali and Fatima and the children and himself. And then the food became extra. They ate and they sent to the neighbors also. They sent some of that food. This is Fatima alayhi salam. Fatima, in her inner beauty, she gathered both beauties, the external and the internal. But what made her Sayyidatu Nisa' al-Alameen was not the external, not the physical or the material. The inner beauty of Fatima, the steadfastness of Fatima, the resilience of Fatima, the patience of Fatima alayhi salam, the forbearance of Fatima made her the greatest lady. She is the embodiment of the divestment of the dunya. Divestment, detachment with this dunya, not being obsessed, withdrawing herself from the dunya. Being zahid. And what is zuhd? Zuhd sometimes is misunderstood. That do not like the dunya. Don't use the dunya. Don't go after the dunya. This is not zuhd. No. This is not zuhd. Because the Holy Quran says, وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Surah Al-Qasas. God says, do not forget your share of this dunya. You have to have a house. You have to have a job. You have to have income. You have to have children. You have to have family. You have to spend. You have to eat well. You have to dress well. But then what is zuhd? Zuhd has been interpreted by the Quran in one sentence. In the Quran, zuhd means لِكَيْ لَا تَأْسَوْ عَلَى مَا فَاتَكُمْ وَلَا تَفْرَحُوا بِمَا آتَاكُمْ. Do not feel despair. Don't despair over that has passed you by. Don't despair. Meaning, do not be attached, so attached and so obsessed to the dunya. Not that you don't use the dunya. The dunya is here for you, the mu'min, to use. But don't be attached to it. Be above the dunya, not below the dunya. Make yourself above the dunya. If you have, you enjoy. If you don't have, you don't destroy yourself. You do not become obsessed with the dunya. لِكَيْ لَا تَأْسَوْ عَلَى مَا فَاتَكُمْ. Do not despair over what has passed you. وَلَا تَفْرَحُوا. On the other hand, do not exult with what you have. What does it mean to exult? It doesn't mean don't become happy. You become happy and joyful and jubilant. But do not mix your joy with arrogance. This is dangerous. Become joyful while you are still humble, remembering God's blessings on you. remembering that this is a gift. One day you get it, one day you may not get it. Do not exult. وَلَا تَفْرَحُ. This exultation should not be mixed with غرور, with conceit, with arrogance. Fatima alayhi salam, she freed herself from this dunya, therefore she became the greatest free woman on earth. And in the hereafter both. In this life, Sayyidatu Nisa'i al-Alameen min al-awwaleen ila al-akhirin. The leader of the master of the ladies from the beginning to the end, because she freed herself from this type of captivity. Sallallahu alayki ya Fatima al-Zahra, ya bint Rasulullah. In your life, you are an example for us. In your departure, in your martyrdom, you are another example for us. And we give condolences to all Muslims, all free people of this world, for the departure of Fatima and her martyrdom on the 13th of Jumada al-Ula. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wal-Asri inna al-insana lafi khusrin illa alladhina amanu wa amilu al-salihat wa tawasaw bil-haqq wa tawasaw bil-sabr wa sallallahu wa sallam ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ahli baytih al-tayyibin al-tahirin. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وصل اللهم وسلم على خلفاء نبيك وأوصيائه وأهل بيته وأحبته علي أمير المؤمنين وقائد الغر المحجلين وعلى البضعة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين وعلى سقطي نبي الرحمة وسيدي شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين عليهما السلام وعلى علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي عجل الله تعالى فرجه وسهل مخرجه وجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه عباد الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي المقصرة المذنبة بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره فقد قال تعالى في كتابه الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون صدق الله العلي العظيم Every night when I go to bed, I start thinking to myself, should I give in to anxiety and fear and intimidation? Or should I free myself of these negative thoughts and have hope and be a hopeful person? And have a trust in God and faith in God and energize myself and my family and my community and those who live around me and tell them that you should not fear. The future is going to be better than the past. This is the thought that goes in my mind almost every night. And our life revolves around this, al-khawf wal-raja. Whether we live in America or live elsewhere, whether you are rich or poor, whether you are American or a citizen of another country, your life revolves between hope on the one hand and optimism on the other hand, on fear and anxiety. Al-khawf wa-raja. Of course, there are legitimate reasons for many people in our community to have anxiety. Not just Muslims, immigrants, even white people, they have anxiety because of what they hear and what they see on a daily basis. Especially the Muslims, when you hear that you do not belong to this country, you are an alien, despite some of you being born and raised on this soil. Despite loving this country, when someone comes and says you don't belong to this country, go back home. And when some people judge you based on your religion, on your color, on your language and culture, not on your virtues and your merits, not on being a human being, but on the color of your skin. And when the highest office in this country says, we bar the Muslim immigrants and refugees from coming to this country, but Christian refugees are welcomed. And when you read a report in the New York Times yesterday that says that this new administration is going to change the CVE into the CIV. Many of you don't know what they stand for. CVE was a program introduced during the administration of Obama, which means countering violent extremism. Any extremism, whether it is white supremacists, whether it is right-wing groups, or Muslims, whether they are Muslims, Jews, Christians, others, they have to be countered. They established a program to counter violent extremism. This administration is changing it from countering violent extremism into countering Islamic extremism only. As if we are the only group and the only people who are extremists. But others, they have no prejudice, no extremism, no radicalism. This is what they are in the making. This is what they are creating now in the White House. Of course, people are going to have anxiety and fear. We don't blame them. When they stigmatize, criminalize only one religion, one group, not only Muslims are going to fear, others are going to fear. I said this last night, 2 days ago. It was Wednesday. We had a meeting here next door in Tustin for Orange County religious leaders. All religions, all religions. There were three rabbis, there were Catholic, you know, leaders, Protestant leaders, Episcopal, Presbyterian, Baptist, there were Zoroastrian, there were Baha'is, there were Sunnis and Shias and others. And all unanimously, they said, we are worried about the conduct of this administration. All of us. And I'm telling you, the Jews, the Jewish rabbi was more even vocal than me. He said, because this president is jeopardizing a democracy that is 250 years old. So not only Muslims are anxious, any human being who believes in justice, who believes in equality, should be concerned, not just the Muslims. But at the end, you know what I say to myself when these thoughts, they come across my mind, the thought of anxiety and fear, or the other one of hope and a trust in God. I remember what Allah says in the Holy Quran. I find refuge in the book of God, in this book. I find happiness and solace in what God says. In Surah Al-Hajj, Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Truly God will defend those who are faithful. يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ خَوَّانٍ كَفُورٍ. Truly God loves not Any person who is any grateful and a traitor does not like them. And if he does not like them, he's not going to help them. He's not going to help them. Asbiru wa sabiru wa rabidu. I always remind myself and my family and others. Asbiru wa sabiru wa rabidu. Asbiru, be patient. Sabiru, help each other to be patient. Wa rabidu, stand your ground. Because you're not doing something wrong. You are doing something right. You are a contribution into this, the safety, the security of the United States of America. And the White House should be proud of the Muslim community in this country. They should be proud of them. These seven countries that they blacklisted, mention one terrorist came from these countries. So this is based on politics, not on the truth. And when the administration, they don't follow the truth, they jeopardize the entire country. And as I said in the past, and I will say, we have the duty of speaking out loud, not to remain silent, not to be intimidated. This is a test. Despite what is happening in America, I still believe this is the best place to live, the best country, because of the inundated support that I have seen nowadays from civic leaders, from faith leaders, from neighbors. Samir Amiri is going to read for you shortly between Hajj Samir, between the two prayers. An example of the letters that we receive from neighbors. They don't put a return address. They prefer to remain anonymous. But see what they tell you. This is a message to all of you. That we love you, we are proud of you. You are Americans. You have the right to live and enjoy living in this country. No one has the right to shut you off. And I'm proud of that. And we have to work even harder and harder, my friends. And I always remind myself of this formidable law in the Holy Quran. Inna Allah, verily, God, la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bianfusih. He would not help unless we help ourselves. Unless we stand for our rights, inshallah. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minin wal mu'minat. Wal muslimin wal muslimat. Al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. Tabi' Allahumma baynana wa baynahum bil khayrat. Innaka mujibu al-da'awat. Innaka ghafiru al-khati'at. Innaka mahi al-sayyi'at. وجاعلها حسنات. Innaka ala kulli shay'in qadir. Allahumma ansur al-islam wal muslimin. اللهم اخذل الشرك والمنافقين اللهم انصر من خدم الدين اللهم أرنا الحق حقا فنتبعه والباطل باطلا فنجتنبه اللهم وحد كلمة المسلمين جميعا على الخير والبر والصلاح والتقوى يا أرحم الراحمين ومن على مرضانا بالشفاء العاجل وإلى أرواح المؤمنين والمؤمنات والشهداء وعجل في فرج سيدنا ومولانا صاحب العصر والزمان وإلى أرواح الأموات ثواب الفاتحة مع الصلاة على محمد وآل محمد